Load. Half being audience, yes, this is where we got last time. Seemed key.
Never walked back on the road from the aged man's abode.
Oh, blazes. Sorry. I know. I can't sing.
There you can. But it's massive cup, like not say massive, I mean wamp cup. Like why is this? It's gotta be at least probably 6 inch high.
Good pipe.
Shut the f. Now I have to go sneak into this place, don't I? And plant bowl. I believe it is. This is pretty funny. And I've got to go to him one side, and he's going to do the other. See what happens?
If they refuse,
then it means war. The gods have befouled the world with their ignorance long enough.
You know, that would mean the deaths of thousands of innocents.
No idolizer is ever innocent.
Religions
are ideologies, and an ideology is a decision.
Daring
those
at...
who don't rebel against their tyrants are...
My quest is to sneak him, right? Position silver plate in the
as the tyrants themselves. But let's see what's going to happen. Who knows? Maybe that old fool Aranthiel will listen to reason. For once in his life.
Yeah, let's see.
Oh wait, mate. Better at sneaking, I can tell you that much. Ooh. I did have one. 8 seconds. I don't believe visibility. Do I have any magic? Damn it. I could have done with some help. With this sneak. Yeah, I might have a bit of armor that could have sneaking. No, it's at home. Oh, see, spook. Oh well. Can't do much about that. I'm pretty sure I shouldn't go in the front door, so let's try to sneak around. Come on. How's a bush gonna stop you? There we go. Oh. Ah. Maybe I have to go in the front. Is something I have. Ah. A goat. Oh, really? Is that a bear? Dead?
Look at that. The urchin
I don't quite know. How am I doing? I'm meant to be putting a plate somewhere. Plate. None? No. I believe I've gone to the wrong place. Either way, I got a kick-ass shield out of it. That's the place? Yeah, I must have gone to the wrong place. What's up with that bear, though? Fucking... Oh, shield though. Rah. That. Shit. Camp. I meant to go up to there and ask him how. Guess that's what I have to do, or I have to climb the mountain. I'm going to say I probably have to go up to the bear and ask him how to get in. Hands are hard. I don't think I'm close. But, yeah. It's locked down. Probably could get up it, but better off just walking over here, really. Seeing what this bear has to say. Be a pretty reasonable guy, if I'm perfectly honest. Okay. I did.
Look at that. The urchin child who just won't stop struggling.
Hey. You tell me.
Use us, you know. How you refuse to give up. How you keep on fighting. Even though deep down you know your struggle is futile.
It's never futile.
Still, you have come a long way. You have ignited the sigil stone. And you have found the beacon. And this urchin child, this amuses us. Because nothing is more entertaining. It's up to you to decide. Come on, urchin. Ask or leave. In the end, you and your people will burn anyway. But sometimes, even the hope for deliverance alone has its merits.
Hey, can I ask this guy's actual questions, please? Ah, thank you.
It's just what you think it is. A weapon that allows you to bring an end to all this.
being.
Yet, a true deity is more than a simple human able to throw fireballs, as your late Lightborn were. A true god is a state of being, and its existence alone forms reality according to its will.
They're already pissing me off.
So many before you, and so many have found the weapon, yet still we exist, and the cleansing is imminent. What does this tell you?
Oh.
Indeed, we are powerful, and we always will be.
Yes, as a ghost bear, a ghost wolf. Who's Spider?
We know what you want to hear now. That you are special, that you have always been. But this is not true. You have been in the wrong place at the wrong time. And the truth is, you make our task easier. You are weak.
Cheers. Wrong there.
They want to destroy the beacon. Amusing, isn't it? They are doing our work for us.
Bastard.
Yes, but they are naive. They believe that the cleansing is a good thing, and that we, the High Ones, have come to raise humanity to a higher stage. Evolution. That is what they call it. Just as the lizard became a dragon, and the bird became a mite. Their leader, Taranar Korak, thinks he is one of the emissaries, just like you.
Clearly not. Obviously, they just want to erase us, don't be silly.
No.
I'll do some of the questions.
Korak considers himself a savior, chosen to guide humanity to a we have never appeared to him like we did to you. You are the only figure of significance in this game, Prophet. Are you so blind? We are the envoys of determination, the constant of being before which time itself bows down. The dream of
okay.
Long which is about to become reality, and that will lead you
to leave me alone, please.
Very well. Now Shu, continue your vain search and forgive us for the pain. Now
son of a bitch.
Samael, my bodyguard, master of Ostium's arena for decades. And to your right, there's Blade Master Alma Sordan, the most gifted sword fighter of Nerim's North and commander of my troops. Furthermore, there's an entire garrison of elite soldiers outside. So, can I trust you to not do anything stupid? I want to talk to you, face to face, as civilized people do.
I bet you take this hood off my head first, and then we can talk to each other.
Fair point. But you forgot to mention that this particular someone tried to sneak into my camp. I think we are square.
Don't be talking about me. I was talking to ghost bears.
Captured your friend as well. He's in a tent up in the camp. And we will compare your stories, so you'd better stick to the truth. Samael, take off the blindfold.
Sup?
Well then, I am Taranor of Korak's blood, former ruler of Kaviat, and now representative of the Free Peoples of Nerim, which you undoubtedly already knew.
Yep.
Who are you?
Like your sword.
I see. And who sent you? And why? Just as I suspected. And how exactly? Of course. We have taken the liberty of stripping you of your belongings. If you'll excuse me for a moment, please.
Sure. I'm happy to sit here looking at this ugly thing in front.
A silver plate. I see. They were sent to spy on us.
Dane!
Then let's kill them.
Bring it.
No.
Untie me, bitch. Honest. See what you got.
I'm a man of my word. And actually, actually, you have done us a favor. We can use the plates to present Aranthiel with our offer without putting ourselves in danger.
That's true.
What? How? What are these plates?
Talking to them, they can hear them.
The Pyreans, their magic works like a sort of ear conch. Sounds are transferred from one plate to the other. And I strongly suspect that at this very moment, Taelor Aranthiel and Narathzel's traitorous heirs are gathered around the counterpart, waiting for someone to activate this plate, aren't they? Samael, do you know how to use these plates? Excellent. Then activate it. I will talk to old Aranthiel. Let's hope that he will listen for once in his life. Otherwise, this will end in disaster.
I won't. Well, that was going to be unsuspicious, wasn't it?
Theodore Aranthiel, I know that you are there and that you can hear me, so why don't we just stop playing games? As you wish, Grandmaster, you can keep quiet, but you should be aware of who's going to pay for your arrogance.
Haven't you had enough war by now? After 2 decades?
Really fucking not.
2 decades of war that were necessary because your god suppressed the people. Or would you deny even this?
Is that why you wanted to talk to me, Quarric? To throw around accusations?
No, that's not what I wanted. We are talking because I want to give you a chance. We know that you are fighting the High Ones, and that you're trying to reconstruct the beacon in order to stop them.
Yes.
Which makes perfect sense, since the cleansing means the end of all life. Don't you agree?
No, I don't. And if you even remotely understood who the High Ones actually are, and what they represent, you wouldn't either.
Hey, you don't either.
The ascendance of humanity to a higher level.
This guy's...
What?
Let's just face the facts for a moment. There's no evidence that the cleansing, whatever shape it will take, will be violent. Yes, the Pyreans are gone, but how do we know they've not just simply gone to another place? That they've transformed? The High Ones are not our enemies, Aranthiel. They are the next step of evolution, the envoys of our purpose, that we might become more than the simple-minded creatures we've been during the past millennia. This is what the cleansing actually is. Don't you understand? It's the moment when humanity is relieved of its vices, united, reaching a higher level of existence.
Guys,
you
just...
That's absurd.
To you, it might sound that way, but I have seen it with my own eyes. Ever since the gods departed, the High Ones have sent me dreams.
No, they haven't.
In which I can see the future and its glory.
No, they haven't.
It's not our destiny to stay human, Aranthiel. With their help, we will be gods, true gods, not the idols you have worshipped. It's the truth, whether you accept it or not.
You're annoying me.
Either. People are dying, Quarric. There's war all over Veen. The dead are rising from their graves, and people are killing each other for no apparent reason. Whatever you have dreamed, does this look like some kind of ascension to you?
Really not.
I know about the Red Madness, but has it ever occurred to you that it follows a pattern as well? That it only befalls certain people?
Whom?
People whose thinking is in shackles. People whose minds are not free and who are superstitious and ignorant, such as the people in your country to whom you have denied the truth about their gods.
What? Are you saying that the Red Madness only affects religious people? People who still believe in the Lightborn?
No, that's got yes. Crazy.
Religiosity is a pattern of thought that favors irrationality over reason. Someone who thinks in these patterns is simply not ready for the advancement, and the Red Madness is simply a way to sieve them out. A natural selection, if you will. That's also why you are not affected by it, Aranthiel. Because you know that what you and your order fought so hard to keep up over the years were lies.
This is nonsense. There have been cases of Red Madness in the Order too, and we have seen what the cleansing will bring us in the dreams and in their chronicles, and it has nothing to do with some kind of ascension. Just listen to yourself, Korek. You talk like a mad prophet. Is that what you want to be?
Yes.
You react just as I expected. Very well then. Will you at least hear our offer?
Speak.
The cleansing has to happen, and we, the free peoples of Nerim, will make sure that it does. We will not allow your backward thinking to keep humanity from advancing as it has done for centuries. Therefore, if you don't want a war, you will stop rebuilding the beacon, and you will tell your people the truth about their gods, so that then they, too, can ascend when the time has come. You've said it yourself, Aranthiel. This world has had enough war. Spare it yet another one.
I would if I could. But if these are your demands, then no.
Then we will have to force you. This means bloodshed, Aranthiel, and innocents will die. And all because...
This conversation is over.
Bloody fool.
You kind of screwed me there.
Alma, prepare the attack. He asked for it.
Yes, my lord. What will happen to the prisoners?
The spies. Right. We're at war now.
Hey.
This means you're my enemies. But as I said, I am a man of my word, and so I'll leave your fate to chance.
It's me.
Samael, put him to sleep, and then put him and his friend on a raft. If they survive, so be it. If not, fair enough.
Asshole. Hey, how you doing? Don't hurt me. Hey! Stop giving me bugs. No, I don't want to sniff that. Hey. Who's that? I was going on a raft. We're here. It's the place at the beginning of the game. Now this is just... I didn't see this. This is fucked up. Really. Oh, a horsey. Oh, two horses. There. Can't deny the absolute beauty of this place apart from the burning corpses. My little kid again. Is daddy gonna fucking burn the house down around me again? Crazy bastard he is. That shit was crazy. Oh. Daddy.
Well, well, look who's here. How are you doing, silly? Still on the search?
Yes.
Is that so? Honestly, I find that a little hard to believe. But, I guess you know what you're doing, don't you? You always did. Come on, let's go inside. I prepared a little surprise, or should I say a big one. I suppose that depends on how you look at it.
There's blood on here, and there's blood on your chest. I've got a bad feeling. kill me.
Ta-da-da-da! Look who I dug out. It's mother and little sister. Aren't they beautiful?
Aren't we beautiful? Aren't we beautiful?
But I suppose what we dead people do doesn't concern you now, does it, my child? Because you are important now. Ha! Can you believe it? He's important now. He is chosen.
Chosen. Chosen.
But you know, I think you've forgotten something. Amidst all this ballyhoo of prophecies, cleansings, and beacons. That you are weak. You are pathetic. You are worthless. And you are weak. That's what you were back then. That's what you are now. And that's what you'll always be. Saving lives? You? Ridiculous. But then again, maybe we do you wrong. So why don't you just tell us? Why you? Why should you, of all people, be the solution to the problem? Why should you be able to prevent something that has happened to mankind for thousands of years? You!
You're fucked up. I don't want to be in the stream. Wake me the fuck up.
That's right. You don't know. Because you are a stupid, dirty brat. A murdering, stupid brat and nothing else.
Stop.
See? You did it again. You made me unhappy. You made me curse. And cursing is a sin. Don't you understand?
Uh-oh.
I'm only trying to help you to see. This Branding is not again. You, don't you understand? You are not yourself. And deep down inside, you know it as much as I do.
You know it. You know it.
This is the most creepiest shit I've ever seen in my life.
Tell me, silly. Why is it so hard for you to just let go? Your place is here. The realm of the dead. So just let yourself fall. It only hurts in the beginning, you know? Then it's like, please, my child. We miss you so much. We'll play with you again.
Play with you. Play with
you. And the two of us. We could go hunting again, like back in the old days. Find ourselves a nice deer, and then have a good, juicy piece of meat for dinner. Do you even listen to me? Hey, you're not supposed to leave yet. You're already here. So why don't you just stay? Please, child, stay with us.
Stay with us.
Stay with us. Stay with us. Stay with us. Stay with us.